I am Nick de Goede, the park manager for the IJs Richtersveld Transfrontier Park on the South African side, which are managed by the South African National Parks, and on the Namibian sides by the Ministry of Environment and Tourism, as well as the Namibian Wildlife Resorts. We manage the Transfrontier Park together towards common goals, not just for conservation, but also for the cultural aspect of the area. Transfrontier Park is a park that's got a common boundary between two different parks into two different countries. It can be more than two different countries, it can be between three or four countries, but they all got a common boundary between each other and are managed towards a common conservation goal. Richtersveld Transfrontier Park, we have a park management committee that developed a joint operation strategy that enables us to take decisions on the ground and to make the park work on a day-to-day basis, and also trying to harmonize the policies and procedures between the two different countries so that we can work towards a common goal, firstly for conservation and then secondly for other issues such as the community participation as well as the tourism products. And a good example of that is the transborder radio network that we have. We have a repeater with a license on both sides of the border, which was issued by both communications authorities of both countries, and it's working extremely well. So we can chat to each other across the border on a day-to-day operation. I think the biggest benefit we have to look at is not just from the conservation point of view, but it's also from the community point of view. We're looking at a community, the Namas, which are divided by an international border. And through the Transfrontier Park, they are now be able to connect to each other again and put up those linkages that was there in the past. So from a community point of view, it's extremely important for them because it's their area and that's the way they've been living for many years. And to try and move away to a boundless border between the community so that it's facilitated the process for the community to get back to each other. And then obviously other issues such as illegal fishing that is taking place along the common border, which is the Orange River. And through the participation of the Park Management Committee and the Joint Operations Strategy, we have now eliminated poaching completely along the river, but also through a process of explaining to the communities why we do it. And there is ways that you are able to do the fishing, but you just do it through the legal ways.